I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart. In my heart, I have but one desire, and that one is you. No other will do. I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just want to be the one you love. And with your admission that you feel the same.
So is that Dan Philip Merlot?
All I'm dreaming of, believe me, I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart.
I don't want to set the world on fire, honey. I love you too much. I just want to start a great big flame down in your heart. You see, way down inside of me, darling, I have only one desire.
Yeah, who's there?
Postman.
Please take a seat, Mr. Malone. It's been a very long time, and a long trip, I'm sure. You must be thirsty. Would you care for a drink?
Bourbon. Straight up.
You were supposed to have been here weeks ago, Mr. Malone. I was beginning to get concerned.
You've been concerned? How do you think I feel about that? Someone else interfered and I had to take extreme measures. I believe you know something about that.
Interfered? What kind of interference?
Interference against people killed, Mr. Grunstrauss. Someone beat me to the dingus.
Okay, so it was one of my men. But he acted on his own. It wasn't supposed to go that way. He was only to keep tabs on you.
Wasn't supposed to go that way? I had no idea that was one of your men. When the authorities found the body, I was harder than a $20 pistol. I had to lay low. I couldn't leave the room. I had the prize, but if the authorities had picked me up, there's no telling where your prize would be.
I see.
No, I don't think you do see, Mr. Grunstrauss. Once the heat died down, I had to find a way to get me and the package out of Egypt. It was touch and go for a while. And it isn't as easy as it used to be to get questionable goods through U.S. Customs. Them boys ask a lot of questions. The more questions, the more expensive it gets. Which brings me to a subject near and dear to my heart, money.
I've been expecting someone. Sylvia Chamon, this is Philip Malone, the man I was telling you about. Sylvia is my personal assistant.
Mr. Malone, I've heard so much about you. Sounds like you lead a very exciting life.
A little too exciting at times. And you?
I'm an art appraiser. I'm assisting Sydney on some projects. Sydney, you need to order more whiskey.
Well, I apologize for the interruption, but our plans have changed somewhat.
Whose plans you talking about?
No, thank you. I don't smoke.
No, thank you. It's bad for your health.
Oh, it's starting to get interesting. Come in, Gunnar.
You told me no one else would be here.
Gunnar, this is Mr. Moreau.
I know who he is. I've been waiting a long time for this.
You see, Mr. Moreau, Gunnar here believes you met his twin brother in Cairo.
Did this to you.
You have a brother? What does he look like?
Let's dispense with this nonsense chatter. Let's get down to business. Now, you do have it with you, don't you?
I told you I have it. You do have money, don't you?
Yes, of course. It's right here.
I'm afraid this isn't going to be enough. I took a lot of chances getting this thing for you. I may never walk straight again. So, I don't think this is going to be enough.
It's going to have to be enough, Mr. Moreau. Gunnar agrees with me, don't you, Gunnar?
I've been waiting a long time for this. I know you killed my brother.
I've never seen you or your brother before.
I know you killed him. He had the suitcase, and now you have the suitcase, and you killed him to get it. Get up. Get up, you son of a bitch, and put your hands in the air.
You see, Mr. Moreau, you're not going to leave. Neither with the money or the dingus. Sylvia and I are going to leave. But you're going to stay here. Miss Guna!
Don't even fucking breathe. Take his gun.
Sylvia, what is the meaning of this? Have you lost your mind? Do you know who I am?
We'll see about that, Sydney. Tie them up and gag them. There's rope in my bag.
Come looking for me, I will find you, and I will kill both of you. It was nice doing business with you boys.
Oh. grab your coat and snatch your hat. Leave your worries on the doorstep. Just direct your feet to the sunny side of the street. Now can't you hear that pitter-pat? And that happy tune is your step. Life can be so sweet on the sunny side of the street. I used to walk in the shade with the blues on parade, no longer afraid. The rover crossed over. If I never had a cent, I'll be rich as Rockefeller. The gold dust at my feet on the sunny side of the street. I used to walk in the shade with those blues on parade, but I'm not afraid, 'cause the rover, he got over. If I never had a cent, I'd be rich as Rockefeller. All those chicks round my feet on the sunny, sunny side of the street.